I'm a founder because I get frustrated when things don't happen. And so when I don't see someone else working on it, I just work on it myself. The more the world becomes digital, the more data gets collected and the more privacy becomes an issue. You know, from artificial intelligence to social network to blockchain, where everything is public, privacy is something we really need to solve once and for all. My name is Ran Hindi. I'm the CEO of Zama. Zama is a company providing open source tools for homomorphic encryption. Homomorphic encryption is a new type of encryption technique where you can process data blindly without actually seeing it. Anybody building an application in the cloud or on a blockchain can now do that without having to worry about privacy or about the security of the data they're processing. When people think about privacy, they often take this narrative that individuals have to take ownership of their own privacy. But when you actually ask people in practice, they don't know how to do that and they don't care. What I believe and what I came to really understand is that the people who can really offer privacy to everyone are application developers. If a developer decides to bring privacy into their product, every one of their users will get privacy without having to worry about it. We're trying to tell people that they shouldn't care about privacy, not because it doesn't matter, but because developers took care of it for them. To give you a couple of examples of applications, today we are working with some companies trying to do machine learning, artificial intelligence, on very sensitive data, such as medical data. For example, if you want to analyze someone's DNA, you want to do that in the cloud because you need the processing power, but you don't want any privacy issue. We don't have to worry about seeing anything about that. So with our technology, you could do blind medical data analysis using artificial intelligence. So that's one use case where you could democratize the use of AI for medical data without having to worry about privacy. Another example is blockchain. On a blockchain, everything is public. And because everything is public, there is no privacy. Everybody knows what you own, what you've been doing. And importantly, everybody now is trying to find a way to profit from what you're going to do by front-running you. Homomorphic encryption is a way where you can have a blockchain exactly as it is today, but where the data you're computing on-chain is encrypted. So nobody actually sees or knows what you're doing. And that solves a million problems from, you know, MEV to on-chain identity to even potentially putting your medical data on-chain. I started thinking about this issue of privacy when I was 14 years old. At the time, I was running a website, a social network, and at some point, I realized that I could access everybody's data, and it just felt fundamentally wrong. So ever since, I've been thinking about ways where you could bring privacy to everything we do online. My previous company was doing that for artificial intelligence, and my new company, Zama, is hoping to do that for everything from blockchain to databases to AI. Privacy was something that I cared about for a very long time that I couldn't see anybody convincingly solving, and that's the reason why I started Zama. Being a repeat entrepreneur makes things a lot easier. You know, the second time, third time you build a company, you know the playbook, especially if those companies are similar in their structure. What's really tough is the first time you build a company, because first you have to find something you're passionate about. If you don't want to dedicate the next, you know, 7 to 10 years of your life on a problem, you're probably not gonna do what's necessary to be successful. As a first-time founder, you tend to want to reinvent the wheel. You want to reinvent how you manage people. You want to reinvent how you raise money, how you structure your company. But the truth is, these are not the important problems to solve for you. The problem to solve is whatever problem you're currently focusing on. One of the biggest pieces of advice I wish I was given was, don't waste your time trying to solve problems that other people already solved before, and really focus on what's new. Building a deep tech company means that there is going to be a lot of effort on research initially, because you're trying to solve a problem nobody solved before. I've invested in over 50 companies inventing new things, and I've built multiples myself, and there's one consistent pattern. If you try to rush your product out before the technology works, you're not going to be able to scale. So it's very important for founders who are trying to build something based on science to take the time it needs and to get the funding they need to get the science right before they can start building a product from it and monetize it. Protocol Labs was instrumental in us being successful so far, because without their support, without the funding they gave us, without the knowledge and network, we wouldn't have been able to focus so much on research. Most investors don't understand how long it takes to solve a really hard problem because they've been used to simple apps and marketplaces and things you can build in 3 months. But science cannot be done in 3 months. Sometimes it takes years, and you need to find the right people who can understand that, and I believe protocol labs are amongst the few. People tend to be lazy when it comes to privacy because they see this as something very complicated. But if you give them the tools, then it makes it easy for them to add a layer of privacy on top of whatever they're already building, then it becomes a question of whether they think this is the right thing to do. And it really only takes one company in a given sector to start thinking about privacy by design for everybody else to follow. So think about messaging apps. Nobody cared about end-to-end encryption in messaging apps. But when WhatsApp turned it on, everybody now thought that this should be the default. And I think that this kind of technology we're building gives the opportunity to make that the case for every product category in the future.